This is both a day to celebrate and a day to rededicate. And let me start with celebration and point out the unexpected upside of the State Department having to reverse itself. You are now one of the very few groups which can go all over the world and say you have official recognition that you are not a terrorist group, and you can show them the State Department decision, and in effect, the State Department has been forced by a judge to admit that you are a group dedicated to freedom and dedicated to liberty, and therefore, anyone who ever again asks you, just pull out, every supporter of the MEK should get a copy of the State Department's statement and carry it around and show it and say, look, this is reality. The only reason the MEK was ever listed was to appease the dictatorship. And the fact is that there's a very bad pattern in our State Department, frankly, under both parties, of always seeking to find a way to excuse once again the dictatorship, which gets me to my second concern. All of you should be dedicated now that you have won this victory to finding a way to carry the case to the news media, to every member of Congress, to the public, that the time has come to recognize that we will never be safe as long as the current dictatorship is in charge. And the only answer is not sanctions, it is not negotiations, it's not deals. The only answer is an all-out effort to bring to bear political, economic, information, and other pressure to replace the dictatorship so that the people of Iran can have a free country and have the opportunity of freedom. I would say to the administration, if you're going to support freedom in Libya, why not freedom in Iran? If you're going to support freedom in Egypt, why not freedom in Iran? If you're going to support freedom in Syria, why not freedom in Iran? What is this blind spot that the one country whose dictatorship is overtly hostile in its language and whose effort to get nuclear weapons is now recognized worldwide is the one country we're not focusing on, whereas if we had any strategic sense, the one country we would place the greatest emphasis on would be helping the people of Iran free themselves from the dictatorship which is currently in charge of the country. Right. We want to stand for genuine freedom for everyone. We want to stand for the opportunity not just to have one election one time, but to have honest, open elections, to have honest, open debate. And the fact is that I believe virtually every younger person in Iran in a secret ballot would vote to change the dictatorship because it has so clearly and decisively failed the aspirations and the hopes of the Iranian people. And so our job is to get that dictatorship to a position of such weakness that it, in fact, it has to cave in and people, in fact, have a chance to be genuinely free. You have a major role to play and communicating this. And I want to really emphasize how proud I am that you're here and how amazed I was by the size of the crowd which gathered in Paris a few months ago. There are enough people who care deeply and passionately about freedom in Iran that if you will reach out to your neighbors and your friends, if you will use your internet and reach out through Facebook and Twitter and email and all the devices, if you will help us educate the Congress and educate the administration, I believe we can set the right goal and we can move in the right direction. Let me expand this and point out that the issue of freedom in Iran, the issue of replacing Ahmadinejad and the dictatorship, is a matter that not only is important to Iranians, but it could easily be a matter of life and death for Americans, for Europeans, for Israelis, and frankly, for all of the Arab states in the Persian Gulf. Ahmadinejad's beliefs make it possible for him to risk a nuclear war. I regard Ahmadinejad as the most dangerous single leader on the planet today and a genuine and direct threat to the United States. I come here not just in support of your hopes and your dreams. I come here on behalf of the American people in support of our hopes and our dreams because we face a common future. It's either a future of freedom, of partnership, of prosperity, of being able to move freely back and forth between our countries, or it's a future of enormous danger in which people who are irrational and hostile acquire bigger and bigger weapons and are more and more capable of bringing about a disaster. What you are doing is important for Iran, but what you're doing is also important for America. And I want you to know that you have my deep commitment to do everything I can to work with you, to work with members of the Congress, to work with members of the executive branch, to develop a strategy to once and for all replace the dictatorship, bring freedom to Iran, and give each of you a chance to participate in a free country. Thank you, good luck, and God bless you.